Welcome to this new Inside Code video where we will discuss a new coding problem, the container with most water problem. So what does this problem say? It says, given an array height that contains the heights of n vertical lines, we want to find the two lines that can form the container that can contain the most water. You're asked to return the area of that water. Note that all heights are positive and that the array will have at least two elements. I think that you will understand better with the visual representation, so here is the first example. I recommend you to pause the video to analyze it. And here is the second one. So try to solve the problem and see you in a few seconds. Before starting, know that you can activate captions and that you can find the solution code in 4 programming languages, Python, Java, C++, and JavaScript in the first link in the description. Now let's start. First of all, given two lines, how can we calculate the area of water that they can contain? We can notice that the container made by those two lines looks like a rectangle, so we can calculate the area by applying the formula of calculating the area of a rectangle, which is height multiplied by length. And in our case, height represents the minimum height between the two lines, and length represents the distance between the two lines. For example, if we have the first line at an index I and the other one at an index g, the area is min of height I and height g multiplied by g minus I. Now that we know this information, we can start searching for the maximum water area. And the brute force solution that we can do is just to check every possible couple of lines while keeping track of the greatest area that we can form. So in Python it would be something like this. We define our function that takes the array of heights as parameter, then we create and initialize our max area to 0 because we didn't start yet. Then for each line, we execute another for loop to traverse all the possible pairs. So we have for I starts at 0 and stops at n, for g starts at I plus 1 and stops at n, we calculate the area between lines I and g by using the formula we've talked about earlier. Then we replace our max area with the maximum between the actual value of max area and the actual area. After it, we just return max area. But you can see that in this solution we are traversing all possible pairs, which gives a time complexity of O n squared. And we can do better, so let's see another solution. The goal of the second solution is to not check all the pairs, so we will use the two pointers technique. And as many solutions that involve two pointers technique, we put one at the first index and one at the last index. We can name them left and right for example. Now to move to the next pair of lines, we have two choices. We can either increment left pointer or decrement right pointer. And to know which one to choose, we can think of it this way. Our goal is to find bigger and bigger lines to make the greatest possible area, right? So what we want to do here is to always move the pointer that points on the small line between height left and height right, in the hope of finding a bigger one. In other words, if height of left is smaller than height of right, we increment left, in the hope of finding a bigger left line. Else, we decrement right pointer. And all that while left and right didn't meet yet, while left is smaller than right. Let's apply this process on this example. First we have max area being equal to 0 and we put our two pointers. We get that area made by the first and last line is equal to 9, so it replaces max area. Our max area is 9 until now. And here, height of left is smaller than height of right, so we move the left pointer. We get that the area is now 16, so it replaces max area, because it's bigger than 9, and we move the right pointer this time. The area is now 7, it doesn't replace max area, and we move the right pointer again. Now the area is 18, it becomes the max area, and we move the left pointer. The area is 10, it doesn't replace max area, and we move the left pointer again. The area is now 0, nothing changes, and we move the left pointer again. The area is now 12, it doesn't replace max area, and we move the right pointer. The area is now 10, and both lines are equal, we can move anyone, let's move the right one. The area is now 2, let's move the right one. And now left and right met, so it's the end of the loop, and we got that the max area is 18, we return it. The Python code of this solution is that we first define our function, then we create an initialized max area to 0, left pointer to the first index, and right pointer to the last index. Then, while left is smaller than right, we calculate the area made by lines at indexes left and right. Then we replace max area with the greatest value between the actual value of max area and the area we calculated now. And we compare our lines to know which pointer to move. If height of left is smaller than height of right, we increment left. Else, we decrement right. After the loop, we just return max area. The time complexity of this solution is O of n because we are just traversing the array once. And the space complexity is O of 1 because we used only simple variables. I hope that you understood these two solutions. Don't forget to give me your feedback on this video in comments, and see you in the next one.